I wrote something that I would like to share with you guys. I wrote it earlier today before I knew I was going to come here and speak to you guys. So, because I think, you know, there's like a lot of you, I thought I was going to send my daughter to school on Wednesday in a pantsuit.
Yeah.
That wasn't the case, so let me just start this. The morning after the election, I woke up and I didn't have a way to express my feelings. Not that I don't have the channels with which to communicate my ideas, although I have limited these channels over the course of the year. But I was unable to fully form them. Deciding instead to navigate this mixture of feelings like a labyrinth in my head. But I knew I had to say something to all of you here tonight, to be in a room full of friends and peers, and not share what was on my mind would have been awkward and also a waste of time, given the state of things. Also, I hate flying, so I decided to try to make this count. And I'm not here to talk about politics so much as talk about human beings and what they're capable of. If I learned anything from my time in the band, I learned that human beings together can achieve great many. From raising spirits, to raising the public consciousness on mental health and depression. This morning, I was outside of my hotel with Tommy Lee Edwards, and we were about to check in. Tommy's a dear friend, a progressive individual, part owner of this convention, and co-creator of Mother Panic, along with Jimmy Hazard and myself. And standing outside with all of our bags, we met an older woman who worked for the hotel. She asked if we were here at the convention, and we said yes. Then she said, thank God. People need comic conventions right now. They need to smile, she said. I see people walk by in their costumes, and they are happy. People need to be happy right now. And that was what I needed to hear the morning after the election. Not a call for violence, but a call for chaos. We're in a room full of creators, all of us. We create art. We also create the environments in which the art can exist. An environment in which we express ourselves. That power is in our hands. By reading, watching, and rooting for our favorite characters, we create a space for them to live in. Without any of you creating that space, we have nothing. If Superman leaves a tall building in a single bound, with no one there to watch, does it really happen? Without us, does Wonder Woman's invisible jet make a sound? Now, I actually don't know if a jet makes a sound. But it would be really silly if it did, right? We would always think she's coming. But whatever. Let's just pretend it's a sound. You are the lifeblood of these characters. You are the heart that pumps the ideas to life. And through these characters, we gain hope and a better understanding of ourselves. No one is sitting on the sidelines. Everyone is an active part of the process of creation. It is why we have museums. Without any of us, where would you put Frida Kahlo? A woman who put revolution to canvas through painting. A woman who turned hardship to agony to beauty. And as we're playing an active part of creation, we are also an active part of this world of what it can become. This world outside of paint and panels. And it is in defeat you find out what you're truly made. And as creators, and everyone in this room is counted among those ranks, we have pens, we have brushes, we have keyboards and typewriters, ink and instruments. We have makeshift capes, duct tape swords, we have makeup, we have masks. And because of these things, we have voices. And with that, we have the ability to change minds and to inspire, like we've always done in the past. And most importantly, we have compassion. That's an important thing. Set you apart from those that do not possess them. So how do I feel? What are my emotions? I usually mask them more, but in a direct way I can say my feelings are of acceptance and moving forward. And yes, like most of you, there is hurt. But the only way to create a movement is by creating the movement within yourself. Get up and keep moving. I'll end this with a quote from Gerard. Jarvis Cocker and the band Paul from a song called The Shapes. Fittingly enough, it goes, "We won't use guns. We won't use bombs. We'll use the one thing we've got more of. That's our mind."